our school performance. Your ranks are this young and this young. I implore to scholars, the parents, administration, and the teachers to value and uphold the importance of fundamental and motivation. It takes a village and a strong leadership team and inspiring people to move mountains, which we do every day at Barack and Michelle Obama Academy. Amazing staff and community that is dedicated and passionate about the success of our scholars. As we continue to soar to limitless greatness, we take the time to recognize two of our own working with integrity, putting children first, displaying dynamic leadership and teamwork, and much more. It is with great pleasure and honor that I welcome you all as we celebrate our 2017 and 2018 Teacher of the Year and Employee Support Personnel of the Year. Ms. Cleveland, Ms. McNeil. Y'all do better than that.
The purpose of the Teacher and Educator Support Personnel of the Year program is to honor those who demonstrate excellence in educating our scholars. Let's take a look at the definition of purpose. Webster defines purpose as something set up as an object or end to be attained, intention, resolution, determination. Both Mrs. Cleveland and Mrs. McGill demonstrate these qualities each and every day as they guide, instruct, affirm, and push our scholars to reach their full potential. When we think of these two extraordinary individuals, we think of such characteristics as
passion, encouragement, courage,
determination,
confidence,
uplifting,
success,
creativity,
inspiring,
joy.
These are just a few of the qualities that our honorees exhibit each and every day. Thank you. We will have Reflections of Mrs. Cleveland by Rachel Bethel.
Mrs. Cleveland is an educator who loves children. She is blessed with three wonderful kids, Eric, Erica, and Malia, which are her life, and a very supportive and loving husband, Kendrick. Teaching children to become successful lifelong learners is her passion. Ms. Cleveland was born and raised in Mobile, Alabama, and relocated to Georgia in August of 2014. This is her third year teaching in Georgia. However, she has been teaching for the past 16 years. So needless to say, she is not new to the methods and styles of teaching. Mrs. Cleveland's hobbies consist of reading, exercising, coaching, enjoying life, and spending time with her family. Lifelong learning has always been a passion of hers. She always wants to know what is new and going on around the world. Therefore, she spends a lot of time learning and studying new methods and ideas. She graduated with honors and earned a bachelor's degree from the University of South Alabama in elementary education. She also has an academic excellence degree in curriculum and instruction, specializing in reading. Not to mention, she is currently working on a doctorate degree in organization and leadership at Grand Canyon University. She has obtained a highly qualified certification in the areas of math, science and social studies, K-8, and reading and language arts, K-12. Her career in education is taken extremely serious, and she spends relentless hours preparing instructional activities and materials for students. She wants to extend a special thanks to her mom, who has always been there for her. She said that she could not have done any of this without her.
Now we have a poem by Rod Stewart.
Mrs. Cleveland, forever I keep your memory stored within my heart. Forever I remember just how you played a part. You played a part by teaching me to think bigger and higher. I will never forget you as for greatness I'll aspire. You played a part by telling me my dreams will all come true. For teaching me how to believe, teacher, I'm thanking you.
We will now have reflections of Mrs. McGill by Talia Middlebrooks.
Ms. McGill is a committed champion of educating our young people. In 1989, she received her Bachelor of Arts degree from Bethune-Cookman College. She has been an educator for over 17 years. Her life goals include educational opportunities for all children and to give them the best she has to offer. The needs and well-being of her students are her top priority. Ms. McGill is a devoted mother of three adult children, all of whom have attended college. She is also very active in the children's ministry. Finally, Ms. McGill will always leave you with these powerful words: nothing beats a failure but a try.
Now we will have a poem by Leah Woods and Celeste Hill.
Ms. McGill, the window of your soul is open to light. You always seem happy and bubbly and bright. You're the type of educator it's a pleasure to know, for beauty goes with you wherever you go.
We say thank you on behalf of all the students' lives you have touched, old and new, for inspiring us to persevere and follow the rules. Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you.
We'll now have video presentations.
All day long, I'm taking
this video. Now we'll have special recognitions from our own Ms. Robin Christian.
Anytime that we can take an opportunity to congratulate our teacher and our paraprofessional of the year, this is an awesome opportunity. We have interrupted instructional time, so we know that this is very, very important. But before I get into my special recognition, I would like to recognize the guest of our teacher of the year. Let's give them a round of applause. Much for joining us, and the guest for our paraprofessional educator support of the year. Let's two individuals that have been with me pretty much along this journey of improving student achievement here at Barack and Michelle Obama Academy, and I could not have asked for what I call soldiers on this battlefield for you all kids to really move the needle of student achievement. So the first person that I want to come down and say a few words for is Ms. Cleveland, if you would come on down. And I'm going to ask, where's Ms. Brown to come up here and join me, the assistant principal? She's probably back there with some students. Okay, if you could come up here. And all of these words I'm going to echo on behalf of the other teachers and faculty and staff here at our school. Ms. Cleveland, I know she's like been crying up there. I've been over there crying too. But I remember actually interviewing Ms. Cleveland. I actually have a very, my memory, it scares me sometimes. And I was reflecting on my interview with Ms. Cleveland, and I remember sitting there thinking that it's something about this individual that I know I want her in front of our kids here. And I want to say I thank you and I appreciate you because you have not let me down. You are always very, very flexible, very patient, relentless about your data. This teacher in 1 year took the fifth grade Lexile scores, 22% of the kids meeting Lexile, to over 50%. Students, if you tell her she can't do something, she'll find a way. Building relationships, students that would not even pick up a book. Last year we were like, okay, can you please put the book down and talk to us? So I just want to commend you. And also, a lot of you all may not know this, but after teaching for long 8-hour days, Ms. Cleveland would leave here and she would go and coach volleyball. And that really is her real passion. She just won't tell anybody. She loves teaching, but she loves volleyball. So if you know anybody, anything about Ms. Cleveland, she loves volleyball. And she took her team to the championship, if I'm not mistaken, correct? APS championship, and they won. And so that alone. She is also one for her district. I talked to Dr. Bachman, the principal at Grady, and she is always like, oh my gosh, I wish I could get her over here to teach for me. I'm like, no, she's not coming to high school. So I just want to commend you. I appreciate you. I just love your spirit and what you give here at Barack and Michelle Obama Academy, and we could not have asked for a more just a symbol of what the master teacher should be like. So on behalf of our school, we have a token of our appreciation. It's beautiful. Whoa. Honoring Barack and Michelle Obama Academy Teacher of the Year, Mrs. Ella Cleveland.
I just want to thank Ms. Cleveland, not only for what she does in the classroom every day and working her practice, but this is a teacher who took feedback from year one, grow and change your practice. And if we can get everybody to do that, that would be amazing. So the fact that you did that is greatly, greatly appreciated. And it's showing off with our students.
So I have the honor of introducing Mrs. McGill. Some of you all may not know this little secret, but not many people follow me over here to what was D.H. Stanton to what is now Barack and Michelle Obama Academy. And so I was very particular about the people that I wanted to be around me on this new journey. because the work that we're doing here is very, very unique. It's turning a school around to make it a better place. So Mrs. McGill, actually, I think only three people, if I'm not mistaken, Caroline, Mrs. McGill, and Ms. Goins. So I want to just, in front of everyone, tell you all that I appreciate Mrs. McGill. When she found out I was coming over here, she was very interested. The second year, I called the principal at my old school, and I said, is it okay if Mrs. McGill comes over here to work? And because it is something about her spirit and the love that she displays for the boys and girls here. You all have seen it in action. This morning I asked her why. I said, why are you here? Because I sent her a message last night to say, I don't need you to come to work. I need you to get ready and be prepared. So this morning when I saw her, it really shocked me. And she said, Ms. Christian, I have to be here at 7 o'clock so I can make sure that the kids have someone when they get to the cafeteria. That's the kind of spirit. Let's give her a round of applause. Thank you so much. She said, I'll leave later. So she could have easily just left downstairs, uncovered, you know, just unsupervised. But she came, she said, it's raining. I just wanted to make sure that I was able to open up the building and make sure that someone was there to greet our kids, because some of our kids need to see Ms. McGill the first thing in the morning. They have to see her to get their day started off right with her positive words. You have also uplifted me as a principal many days where, you know, I'm like, wow, this is some really hard work, your words of inspiration. And I really appreciate your team player spirit, your positive words, your positive affirmations. Let me see, kindergartners, if you're in Ms. McGill's class, stand up. Let me see, Ms. McGill, what is it you do? Which one?
All right, ready position? Rule number one. Rule number two.
She pours it to our kids. So I just want to tell you, I appreciate you and everything that you've done here, and just what you contribute to our overall school. So on behalf of our school faculty and staff, we have a beautiful, beautiful recognition plaque that reads, Honoring Barack and Michelle Obama Academy 2017-18, Educator Support Personnel of the Year, Mrs. Tina McGill, for your educational leadership, service, and dedication. Thank you.
Yeah, I just want to say, Mrs. McGill's consistency is amazing, and then her tenacity at always seeing all the children in the building, whether they're her responsibility or not, is an absolute wonderful trait to have. Thank you very much, Ms. McGill.
In closing, the teacher and the support faculty member is a great and big thing to the field of education. This is always a wonderful experience to share, and a great partnership we have here with community, family, school, and friends. And on behalf of myself, the business manager of the school, I would like to thank each and every one of you for being here this evening and participating in this joyous event.